Welcome everyone to TWA's Vortex Pay-Per-View, live at the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Don't worry, tickets here don't cost a fortune, unlike a certain team that's only been around for 1 year.
Hello everyone, RJ Peckham alongside my broadcast colleague Mark Adams. Tonight, Mark, the main event will be Gigant defending his primetime championship and his streak against Iron Man. Normally, the TWA championship would be defended in the main event, but not this time around because Django, the TWA champion, is holding the title up for ransom, and there's still no word on whether he will return or give the title back. But we will, of course, open our show with some TWA Women's Championship action. Wonder Woman will put her woman's title on the line against Santina, who will be getting her first woman's title shot since she lost the belt at Telethon 7.
To Wonder Woman.
Of course, Barbie will be at ringside, trying to make sure that her new girlfriend of sorts will walk out of the T-Mobile Arena with the woman's title around her waist for the second time. We got an audience that's so fired up here in Vegas. Let's start the show.
Our opening contest, scheduled for one fall, is for the TWA Women's Championship. Introducing first, the challenger from Boston, Massachusetts, weighing in at 108 pounds, Santina!
Huh, no Barbie.
And her opponent, from the Masira, weighing in at 148 pounds, she is the TWA Women's Champion, Wonder Woman!
Hey, production truck, would you mind turning down the wattage on those lights just a little bit, please?
This is Santina's first shot at regaining the TWA Women's title that she lost at Telethon 7 to that very woman, Wonder Woman. And Barbie has been challenging Santina's limits, so to speak. A couple of battlefronts ago, Barbie dared Santina to strike Rey with a chair, but she didn't do it. But on the previous battlefront, Barbie dared Santina to strike Wonder Woman, and she did. Wonder Woman, of course, has been trying to reason with Santina, telling her that Barbie is using her. However, I don't think Santina's going to listen to reason because she wants that belt back. Very strange to see Santina taking the path that she has now. Here's the bell. Wonder Woman, the woman's champion, starting off strong with a backbreaker. There's an elbow for good measure.
It doesn't look like Wonder Woman forgot when Santina hit her with that chair.
And Santina trying to take the legs out from Wonder Woman. Wonder Woman is mostly based on a powerful offense. So Santina is
probably going to have to keep Wonder Woman off of her vertical base if she wants to continue having the advantage and walk out of the T-Mobile Arena with the Women's Championship for the second time. And there was a forearm. Irish whip to the corner. Santina quickly gets out of the way. Oh! Santina with an enziguri kick. And Wonder Woman's head nearly got decapitated on the third rope at the bottom. One count, but that's all Santina got. She still has a long way to go before dethroning Wonder Woman of her belt.
Do you think maybe Santina, like she did a few months ago, told Barbie that she didn't want her to interfere?
I don't think so. I mean, it's been well established now that Santina and Barbie have become an item. And after that steel chair shot that Santina committed against Wonder Woman, I think it's safe to say that Santina and Barbie are together. And here's one. Maybe Santina is asking Barbie to wait and come out later in case if the match doesn't work in her favor. So far, when it comes to a power match, Wonder Woman is winning. But we don't have judges giving out scores. The only way to win is through pinfall or submission. And one. Two. Only two. Wonder Woman arguing that that could have been a faster count, but I gotta disagree. I think referee Jordan Peterson's count was right on the spot.
It seems like a lot of wrestlers lately have been getting impatient with the referee's count.
One. Well, only a one count there. And Wonder Woman just really used her legs to wrench the spine of Santina. Wonder Woman flattening Santina. Wonder Woman going high risk. She's daring her to get up. She's got to do her damage now. And there's the go around. And here's the pin. Come on, ref. One. Two. No.
I bet Santina's been in that position before.
Ha ha ha. Wonder Woman just nearly got the victory with the go-around. Santina with a jawjacker. Santina in the driver's seat so far. And there was a wrench on the forearm. Santina with a blatant kick to Wonder Woman's face there. Santina now going to work on the arms. Santina must realize that that's where Wonder Woman's strength lies. There's a neck breaker. And a pin. One. Or was that even a one? Santina's perplexed by that one. Oh. and Wonder Woman with a pump handle to a backbreaker. Wait a minute, that's Anna! What is Anna doing out there? And Wonder Woman is not taking too kindly to Anna's interference, and Santina finds the opportunity to strike from behind, and there's a sunset split. And here's the pin. Come on, don't let it end this way. Two. Oh, only two. And Anna cannot believe it.
Why is she even here?
I don't know. I don't know what Anna's business with Wonder Woman is. And Santina.
You're welcome.
Oh! And oh! Santina just got bulldogged by Wonder Woman. And Wonder Woman goes after Anna for good measure. Good riddance.
It seems even Santina didn't like Anna's interference.
I still struggle what Anna has to do with either one of the challengers in that either one of the competitors in that ring. Santina nails Wonder Woman with a drop kick, and now going high risk. But, oh! Santina took too much time, and Wonder Woman thought quick on her feet. Massive gorilla press slam! And here's the pin. One. Two. No. Only a two count. But I think Wonder Woman is drawing even nearer towards the lasso of truth. Oh, Santina with a drop kick. Hard forearm elbow. And now Wonder Woman picking up Santina's corpse, and a power bomb.
Oh, here she comes.
Oh, and here comes Barbie. Knowing that this was going to happen, Barbie distracting Wonder Woman. Get her away from that ring, ref. Oh, Santina finds the opportunity thanks to Barbie's interference. Santina is now back in the driver's seat. And Santina with a hard spear to Wonder Woman. She's now on the outside. Santina, what is she doing? Going high risk? Oh! Dropkick on Wonder Woman. That had to hurt. Wonder Woman is now in a tizzy. However, Santina cannot win the woman's title on the floor. Both competitors are back in. There's a hip toss, segueing into a knee to the face of Wonder Woman. Here's the pin. One. Once again, only a one count. But now the frustration is really building on Santina's face. Now Wonder Woman with a hard forearm smash. Once again, going high risk. I think we're going to see the go around again. Oh no! Instead, clothesline from the top rope. Here's the pin. One. Two. No! Santina's been gutting it out pretty good. And, uh-oh, Wonder Woman. Don't turn your back on Santina. Don't let Barbie distract you. Needless to say, that distraction by Barbie cost Wonder Woman, albeit briefly, but now the woman's champion is back in the driver's seat again. Inverted DDT. Now Wonder Woman just yanking the spine of Santina. And now Wonder Woman retreating to the outside, trying to take a breather. She can afford to do so. Oh, Santina with a double axe handle. Santina knows that if she keeps Wonder Woman on the outside, she won't be able to win the woman's title. And now Wonder Woman going high risk once again. I think this is it. This is going to be the go around again. There it is. But no pin this time. I think she's getting ready to go for the lasso of truth. But oh, Santina gets out of the way, and now she's clipping the knees of Wonder Woman from under her. And oh, belly-to-belly suplex by Wonder Woman. She feels it. The crowd in T-Mobile in Las Vegas feel it, but Barbie is not feeling it. She's trying her best to distract Wonder Woman, but to no avail. Hard boot.
I don't know how much more Santina can take.
She's been gutting it out pretty good, but I think she can only go so far. Santina with a hard clothesline. Santina once again weakening Wonder Woman's arms using the armbar. We're still far away from declaring a winner. Santina going for the arms. But, oh, Wonder Woman with a rock bottom of her own. Irish whip to the corner. There's the Amazonian splash. And Wonder Woman going for the pin. One, two, no! Only two. And Wonder Woman, the woman's champion is getting really frustrated. Now she's going for the arm bar again. And there's the showstopper. This has got to be it. Here's the... And Barbie once again causing trouble, getting up on the apron.
If Barbie really loves Santina, maybe she should just let Wonder Woman win because she's killing her now.
Wonder Woman throws Santina to the outside. So far, as it relates to this match, Wonder Woman is winning on strength, but Santina is winning on toughness. Massive clothesline by Wonder Woman. Hard fist. I think that was a closed fist right there. Now Santina, I think she's trying to go for the winner's nap. Here it is. There's the winner's nap. Wonder Woman. Wait a minute. Using her strength to power out. Unbelievable. And Wonder Woman strikes back. Inverted DDT. Wonder Woman once again going high risk. Are we going to see the go around for the third time? There it is. And oh, wait a minute. No, no. Oh, power bomb by Santina. And now she's going for the twerk salt. Nails it. Barbie getting all excited. There's a sunset split once again. Santina hits it, but oh, Wonder Woman, she just got right back up. And now Wonder Woman has got the lasso of truth on Santina. But once again, Barbie has the referee distracted. Wonder Woman, I think, has just had it up to here with Barbie. And Barbie, of course, is running away from Wonder Woman. She can only go so far. And oh, Santina with a drop kick to Wonder Woman. And Barbie taunting her. Wonder Woman all disoriented. And once again, sunset split for the third time. And here's the pin. One, two. Oh, again, only two. Hard to believe we still don't have a winner at this point. Amazonian splash once again. But now Barbie once again getting into the ring. Getting into the face of the women's champion. Brings over her fist. And referee Jordan Peterson has had enough of Barbie's interference, ordering that she leave. But wait a minute. Wait, Santina. Pinfall. One, two, oh, very close, very, very close. Santina was just 2¾ away from upsetting the women's champion. And now here comes the sunset split for the fourth time. But Santina is tired. Here's the pin. One, two, three. Santina wins the women's championship for the second time.
Winner of this bout and new TWA Women's Champion, Santina.
Barbie, without a doubt, to celebrate Santina's win.
Wait a second.
And that's Elvira, the Women's Bank Heist winner. Looks like she's gonna cash in her woman's title shot.
Hold on a sec, Petey. Before you ring the bell, I am declaring that the bank heist cash-in is a triple threat match.
Triple threat? Why?
Wait. Oh! Barbie just nailed Santina from
behind with a steel chair, and what? And now, what is this all? This is about it, Barbie.
No!
Winner of this bout and new TWA Women's Champion, Barbie!
I think I need some Tylenol.
Are you telling me that Elvira was happy to give up her bank heist to her?
I can't think of anyone more undeserving of that belt than that harlot, Barbie, who has caused nothing but trouble since her TWA debut. This is an outrage. This really shouldn't have been allowed to be sanctioned. Santina, she's confused. This woman destroyed Santina's relationship with Justin Boner. And it's like, considering Elvira had a little affair of sorts with Boner, it's like Elvira and Barbie planned this plot the whole time to tear them apart.
Oh, I can't think of a more disgusting duo than Barbie and Elvira. This is disgusting.
Why would you sanction a match without my permission?
Because Machete deserves to feel Captain Rhodes' wrath!
So you booked this match for no reason other than to see Machete get hurt?
Yes, because these anarchists need to be reminded who's in charge here!
This doesn't help my cause, Billy. You're just making me look like a spiteful tyrant.
Somebody has to do something about them! I did! Are we on the same page, Indy? Or not?
You know what, Billy? I don't know.
The TWA doesn't negotiate with terrorists! We need to make that clear!
And here is that match that Billy Mays sanctioned.
Machete going up against Captain Rhodes. An impromptu match, so to speak. Captain Rhodes is still full of piss and vinegar after his moment to shine when he won the TWA Championship was taken away from him when Django cashed in his bank heist and won the belt from him. Now he's looking to unleash his anger on someone, and that someone is going to be Django's friend and tag team partner, Machete.
The following contest, scheduled for one fall, is a hardcore match! Introducing first, from Mexico, weighing in 188 pounds.
And oh! Captain Rhodes wasting no time going after Machete! I don't think the bell is rung yet.
I don't see what Jones was complaining about earlier. Rhodes has every right to be mad about what happened, and he has every right to take it out on this guy.
And Rhodes, with a Singapore cane, swinging it across Machete. And of course, it's all legal, it's a hardcore match.
Not to mention, why did Jones feel the need to lock Rhodes in the Raiders' locked last battlefront?
I don't know. Maybe Indiana Jones, he's under a severe amount of stress having to deal with the inmates trying to run the TWA asylum. First Django holding the TWA title hostage. Now we have the Walt Disney Corporation coming in and attempting a hostile takeover of the 20th Century Fox division. With all this stuff, no wonder Indy's under a severe amount of stress. Machete with a half suplex, half backbreaker. One. Rhodes with a hard clothesline to the back of Machete's neck. Rhodes now taking it to the next level, exposing the turnbuckle. Oh! And now Rhodes, what's he gonna do here? Massive drop kick sends Machete to the outside. Of course, there are no countouts, and of course, no disqualifications. And a hard steel chair shot. I think Captain Rhodes would like to reacquaint Machete with the Spanish announce table. Now Machete, he's got a sledgehammer right to the gut of Rhodes. Machete completed his damage right there. One. But he only got a one count out of it. Ever since Machete got a hold of the sledgehammer, he now has the advantage. Machete daring Rhodes to get up. And double axe handle, but Captain Rhodes fires back with a punch. One. Only a one count. Captain Rhodes hoping to bring more weapons into the equation. Another steel chair, but Machete forces him to drop it. Massive clothesline, almost decapitated.
These two getting very close to Hose A and Hose B.
What does that mean? Oh, the Spanish announce table guys, okay. I don't know why Rhodes is waiting. He could nail Machete with a steel chair at any time. Oh! No. Massive DET. Machete getting rammed into the steel steps. Captain Rhodes using the steel steps as a tag team partner. Rhodes with a hard shot using the steel steps, and Machete is busted open. He is donning the crimson mask. He is bleeding. But Machete is not throwing in the towel just yet. And of course, a hardcore match is not going to end on a blood stoppage. And Machete, I guess, is hoping to bust Captain Rhodes open, much like Rhodes did to him. Rhodes superplex right from the top rope.
Maybe this match actually isn't a good idea.
One, two, no, only two.
What I mean by that is Rhodes is going to beat Machete up so viciously and so badly, he may scare Django so much that he'll never return.
I don't know if that theory holds up, but we'll see. Machete with a couple of boxing jabs. Machete scoop slams Captain Rhodes onto the ropes. And there's, I guess, a forward Samoan drop, so to speak. One, two, no, only two. And Machete arguing that the count could be faster, much like Wonder Woman did earlier in the women's title match. I still can't get over the fact that Barbie, of all people, is the new women's champion.
Yeah, that's a first. Someone winning no matches whatsoever and becoming a champion.
Rhodes with a pin. One, two. Now Rhodes, of course he's going to be upset with the count. He has multiple times in the past been upset with referees. Of course, there's not much the referee can do because there are no rules. Singapore Cane shot, and Machete went to the outside briefly, but he comes right back in and a hard boxing jab. And he drops Captain Rhodes on his face swiftly. And here's Machete going for the pin. One. Oh! Only a one count, and it could be argued that the referee took too much time to finally position himself to make the pinfall. And the Machete pump handle slam. Machete with a pin. Once again, referee taking a little too much time. One, two, no! Captain Rhodes, hard kick. And there's the military DDT. This could be setting him up for the crossroads, but instead, Rhodes going for the pin. One, two, only two. Rhodes, he's getting ready. Here comes the crossroads. Oh! Here's the pin. One, two, only two. Rhodes, he's already bent out of shape over losing the TWA title. He's got to be even further bent out of shape since the crossroads did not deliver him the win. There's a double underhook suplex. steel steps, just resting on the ropes there. Now, what's Machete gonna do? Snake eyes! But Captain Rhodes comes right back. Now, looks like Rhodes is bringing in the big guns. He's bringing in the table. Machete setting the table back in its original form. Machete with a hard clothesline. Here's the pin. And one. Only a one count. This has got to be the third time now where the referee has been in bad positions. And it could be argued that Machete could have had the match won if it wasn't for the ref mistiming his positions. And now, Captain Rhodes, German suplex to Machete. Machete seems to be losing more blood by the second. Oh boy. Captain Rhodes, I think I know what he has in mind. He's going to superplex Machete into the table. Here it is. Oh, Jesus Christ, superstar. That's probably going to be the clincher. One. Two. How did Machete kick out of a superplex into a table?
Just keep on track, Rhodes. He's losing blood. He'll pass out eventually.
Hard clothesline. Machete with a rib breaker. He's kind of tangled in the ropes there. Captain Rhodes with a knee right across Machete's throat. There's the crossroads for the second time.
Now that should be it.
Here's the pin. One, two, three. Rhodes is the winner.
Here's your winner, Captain Rhodes!
Well, Captain Rhodes gets a victory, but I don't know if he's going to be completely satisfied unless he gets the TWA Championship back. Nonetheless, he made mincemeat out of Machete.
Django, if you don't bring your ass and my TWA title out here right now, I'm going to knock this spick's head off! Okay, time's up! Rhodes, stop this!
Oh, him again.
He's had enough. Just let him be. Please.
Do it, Rhodes.
And oh! Rhodes just hit Machete anyway with a baseball bat.
Why does Jones seem to think it's necessary to protect these anarchists?
Well, nonetheless, even though Jones told Rhodes to stop, he wouldn't listen anyway and nailed Machete with a baseball bat. Needless to say, I think Jones, throughout his best efforts, he's still losing control over the TWA as time goes on. Coming up next, folks, the Tag Team Championship to be decided, as Friday the 31st, Jason and Michael will put their tag team titles on the line against Big Trouble. Jason and Michael just came off an incredible TWA tag team title defense in, dare I say, the match of the year against Scorpion and Sub-Zero at Fallout. But now they're meeting challengers of a different kind in the form of Ash and Jack Burton, who had seen some success finally when they decided to join together as a team. But will this success transfer to the tag team titles?
The following tag team contest, scheduled for one fall, is for the TWA TV Tag Team Championship. Introducing first, the challengers, at a total combined weight of 425 pounds, Big Trouble!
I think we've moved down a couple of tiers from Scorpion and Sub-Zero.
Well, we can never know for sure. What if Ash and Jack Burton actually do rise to the occasion? I know the odds are still stacked against them, but we'll see if these two have any tricks up their sleeve that might equate to them leaving Las Vegas with the tag team belts.
Nah, I saw what I needed to see last Battlefront from their failed sneak attack.
And their opponents, at a total combined weight of 525 pounds, they are the TWA TV Tag Team Champions, Friday the 31st.
No duo has been able to stop these two, and I can't think of many more duos that are left to rise to the challenge.
Now, it's obvious that Ash and Jack Burton are going to have to come up with a unique strategy to try to beat Jason and Michael for the tag team titles. But what strategy would be done? Because normally I would say you would have to prolong the match. But we saw Michael and Jason go to the limit when they faced Scorpion and Sub-Zero for the tag team titles. That match went like roughly 20 minutes. And Friday the 31st still walked out with the tag team belts around their waist. So we know they're not really short of energy. And Michael just knocked out Jack Burton. Swing a neck breaker. Jack Burton was in the driver's seat briefly, but now Michael Myers has the advantage. And now the tag's been made to Jason. Jason gripping Jack Burton by the throat.
I know this may be a little early, but because of all their tag team wins, Jason and Michael have a comfy lead in the Paramount division in terms of King of the Tube points. And they can make their lead even more comfy with another win here tonight.
Jack Burton makes the tag to Ash. Ash just got knocked from behind by Jason, and Jason just knocked Jack Burton off the apron. Nonetheless, that gave Ash an opening. Since this show is in Las Vegas, what are Ash and Jack Burton planning to do should they win the tag team titles? Are they going to call an escort service?
Yeah, that sounds about right. And then they're going to both brag about all their adventures with the dead.
Well, they'd be half right in this case, because we know Jason's dead, but Michael, he's alive as far as we know. Jason with a tag to Michael. Boot to the face. Jack Burton begging for a tag from Ash. Hard decapitation clothesline courtesy of Michael Myers. There's a belly to belly. Ash trying to crawl to Jack Burton, but Michael is not going to have any of that. Michael, he's going to continue to taunt Jack Burton on the outside there by continuing to beat up on Ash. Massive scoop slam. Hard fist. And there's a vice grip. Ash must be at least unconscious right there. Michael daring Ash to get up. Choke slam! Right in the center of the ring. This could be it. Here's the pin. One. And Jack Burton saves his team from certain doom. And I believe that Michael is still the legal man. Just ram Jack Burton into the steel steps. He can't take his eye off Ash. Well, it seems that Ash and Jack Burton are in big trouble right now. Pardon the pun. But wait a minute, Ash comes right back. And Ash just nailed Michael Myers just slightly above the belt.
Yeah, in the one place where Michael feels pain.
Ash makes the tag, Jack Burton. And Michael Myers greets him with a hard fist. Irish whip to the corner. Michael tags in Jason. Looks like we're going to see some double team action coming right up. Jason and Michael. Jason just tossed Jack Burton. Now Jack Burton coming right back with a unique slam right there. Jack trying to get the crowd in Vegas on his side. But I can't help but think that half the crowd is actually for the tag team champions, Jason and Michael. Jack Burton was on a roll until Jason comes right back on his feet. And now Jason's got the vice grip and he flattens Jack Burton like a pancake. Jason now makes the tag to Michael. What we're going to see here now looks like double choke slam. And Michael just knocked Ash off the apron. Goes for the pin. One, two, three. Convincing victory for Jason and Michael.
The winners of this bout. And still, TV Tag Team Champions, Friday the 31st.
Much of the same.
Well, not exactly as long as the matchup between Scorpion and Sub-Zero, but nonetheless, big trouble. They tried. Ash and Jack Burton did the best they could in the match against Jason and Michael, but they came up short, and now they're going to have to retreat to the back of the line. I don't know who's going to be able to beat Jason and Michael for the TV Tag Team titles now. I pity the next team who has to face them. And speaking of pity, coming up next, the Blockbuster Championship to be decided as Bane will defend the Blockbuster title against Jack Torrance. Now, I don't know who to actually pity in this match. Do I pity the challenger, Jack Torrance, or do I actually pity Bane? Because considering Bane is the Blockbuster champion, but he's going up against a challenger who will destroy anybody, even himself, if it means he walks out with that belt around his waist.
The following contest, scheduled for one fall, is for the TWA Blockbuster Championship. first, the challenger from Vermont, weighing in at 212 pounds, Jack Torrance.
Jack Torrance, coming off a convincing victory over Alex DeLarge in the first ever dumpster match. Now he's got possibly the biggest challenge of his life against Bane.
His opponent, from the pit, weighing in at 285 pounds, he is the TWA Blockbuster Champion, Bane!
Much like Jason and Michael, Bane is standing atop his respective division in the King of the Tube standings. This match can help not only for helping Bane's cause as TWA's reckoning, but will also put a bit more distance between the two in the Warner Brothers division.
You're of course speaking about the King of the Two Points. Not only will it create distance there, but if Torrance loses in this matchup, there will be more distance as he has to go to the back of the line. Now, of course, this is a regular match for the Blockbuster title. So Jack Torrance needs to be careful of himself, because when he enters that zone, he goes to a different level, and oftentimes it doesn't pay off in dividends. He gets himself disqualified. He ends up making a mistake. And as documented by Tarzan losing the title to Bane at Telethon 7, all it takes is one mistake and Bane can capitalize and end the match for you instantly. And here's the bell. And Jack Torrance tried to make a run at Bane, but it didn't faze him. There's an elbow.
I hope Jack has Mr. Grady, Lloyd, and all the other ghosts at the Overlook in his corner, because he's going to need them all.
And we know this match is not going to be catch-as-catch-can style. Neither of these men are known to be finesse in terms of their wrestling style. Bane has always been a power man. Jack Torrance has been more of a strategist, more of a scrapper than anything else. And considering the maniacal tendencies of both of these individuals, or should I say, homicidal tendencies of these individuals, this is not going to be pretty. Jack Torrance with a pin. One. Maybe if I was Jack Torrance, I would want to prolong the match, because Bane's oxygen supply is only going to run for so long.
up.
And oh, Jack Torrance just tripped Bane up. Bane with a hard clothesline. Here's the pin. One. Only a one count. Jack is still in the game. But now Bane showing that raw power that has pretty much everyone in the TWA locker room terrified. This is the man that broke Batman's spine. This is the man who defeated Frankenstein on an episode of Battlefront. But Jack Torrance is showing no intimidation whatsoever of Bane. And he cannot afford to show any intimidation, because if he wants to beat Bane and become the new Blockbuster champion, he has to show that he's willing to do anything and everything to win that belt. Hard clothesline. Nearly decapitated Bane right there. Hard chop. Jack is feeling it, and the crowd in the T-Mobile Arena in Vegas is feeling it. Of course, since this is Vegas, Jack Torrance doesn't have to worry about any cold conditions. There's a Luthez press, and Jack Torrance just really ramming away at Bane's cranium.
I think he might have been trying to rip off his mask, too.
And Bane, power bump! Jesus Christ, superstar! Jack Torrance just got power bombed right to the outside. And Bane is not through yet. How could Jack even stand at that point? And now we got a Donnybrook on the outside. It's not going to solve anything if these two men get counted out. My guess is Jack is going to use the 10 count on the outside and the 5 count on the inside, anything he can to keep the advantage over Bane. Oh, Jack Torrance accidentally dived on referee Jordan Peterson, and Bane now seizes the opportunity. Here's the pin, but the referee's still knocked out. Bane in the right place at the wrong time. And Jack Torrance this time dives on Bane, wailing on his noggin. The referee's not calling for the disqualification because it wasn't intentional. Bane with a hard gorilla press segueing into a knee to the gut. And now Bane using those massive arms for a chin lock. But Jack is not through yet. Going for the elbow. Jack Torrance has really been aiming for the cranium of Bane. I guess in Jack Torrance's mind that if you cut the head or the air supply off a snake, if you will, then the rest is easy. Nonetheless, Bane had the advantage briefly, and now Jack Torrance comes right back with a jaw jacker. gotta say, Jack has been really showing some mettle here, really being good on the offense. Of course, things can still change in the drop of a hat. Two scrapping on the outside, but they come back in. And now Jack Torrance getting ready to go for the kill. Is it the overlook he's aiming for? The overlook pile driver crunching him. Oh! Dropped Bane right on his neck. And what's Jack doing? Why didn't he go for the pin?
You stupid dumbass. You're gonna get yourself disqualified.
Jack Torrance, I think he's entered that zone. There could be no other explanation. He could have had the opportunity to go for the pin, but he didn't do it. And now he's got the ladder, and if he uses that, he is gonna get himself disqualified. But wait a minute. What's he gonna do here? Jack got suicidal tendencies now, but oh, and Jack made a mistake just like Tarzan did at Telethon 7, and looks like the end could be near. Bane tosses the ladder aside. The rest is probably elementary from here. Fall away slam. It's only going to be a matter of time before we see the coma driver.
You had him. You hit your finisher. He was down. Why the hell didn't you just pin him right there, you stupid fuck?
Pardon Mark's French there.
If Alex had won the dumpster match and gotten here, he wouldn't have made a dumb mistake like that.
You don't know that. The balls are now in Bane's court right now. And a hard knee. A second knee for good measure. Bane demanding that Jack Torrance get up. It's only be a matter of time before we see the coma driver. Oh, wait a minute. Jack Torrance still has some life left in him. Hard clothesline. Going for a fist, but Bane stops him. And now, oh. We've seen that before. Bane contorting Jack's neck in a compromising manner. Bane just taunting the crowd here in Vegas. Now Bane going to work on the leg of Jack Torrance. Once again, Bane asserting to the crowd that he is TWA's reckoning. And there's the coma driver. And here's the pin. One, two, three. Bane retains the Blockbuster title.
The winner of this bout, and still Blockbuster champion, Bane!
obviously doesn't watch video review.
Jack Torrance, he had the match won. With the overlooked pile driver, he should have made the pinfall on Bane, but instead, he went out of that zone, and he decided to inflict more damage, and once again, that mistake cost him, and Bane capitalized from there. He is still the Blockbuster Champion. Coming up next, folks, we got Women's Tag Team Championship action, as we will see the Super Smash Sisters in their first Women's Tag Team title defense, taking on Kitana and Melina. And of course, the Super Smash Sisters have not been allowed to defend the Women's Tag Team title since Samus had been out with an ankle injury, but she's making the valiant effort to be here tonight and defend the Women's Tag Team titles. Kitana and Melina tried to hurt Daisy and put her out of commission, but to no avail. These women are here, and they are ready to fight.
The following tag team contest, scheduled for one fall, is for the TWA Women's Tag Team Championship.
Well, there's the challengers, Kitana and Melina. They, of course, wrestled the Super Smash Sisters in the finals of the women's tournament. Came up short, and Kitana and Melina have been bitter about it ever since because they truly believe that they are the superior team, that they should be the women's tag team champions, not Samus and Daisy.
They have made it clear that they feel this women's tag team division was created because of them.
They're gonna have to step up and actually win this match in order to prove it. There's the women's tag team champions getting a hell of a greet from the crowd here in Vegas. Samus's size, Daisy's grit, two combustible elements like that, and you have a very popular and effective tag team.
Introducing first, the challengers, at a total combined weight of 254 pounds, Kitana and Melina! And their opponents, at a total combined weight of 339 pounds, they are the TWA Women's Tag Team Champions, the Super Smash Sisters!
I like Kitana's new attire. It's actually blue, not that stupid teal that she was wearing for all those months.
And Kitana, starting off strong with a forearm smash to Daisy, but Daisy comes right back with a clip.
Oh, so Samus, she's just fine, huh? No leg injury? Then why did Daisy start the match?
Thank you. Well, I don't have the information as to whether or not Samus's ankle is fully healed or not. I'm just saying that she's making the heroic effort to defend the belts regardless. Katana knocks Daisy to the outside, but of course, they cannot win the tag team titles on the floor. If it stays a wrestling match, then the challengers, Katana and Melina, will have the advantage. But if it turns into a high-flying exhibition, then the advantage lies with the women's tag team champions, Daisy and Samus. There's a jaw jacker. Samus wants a tag, and there it is. We're gonna see what Samus can do. Katana with an elbow. Irish whip. Samus picking up Katana's carcass into a sit-down powerbomb. And now, Katana with, I think, is it a sharpshooter or a Texas cloverleaf? But Samus nevertheless flips out of it. She was going to try to weaken the ankle once again of Samus. Katana showing some quickness of her own, and she's going right after those feet. I don't know if that was the same ankle that Samus broke or not. Now Melina is in the ring, and she's focusing on the legs of Samus. They're going to try to weaken those feet. They're going to make sure to neutralize the women's tag team champions. They're going to try to isolate and destroy Samus. And then Daisy. We saw what Katana and Melina did to Daisy on the one battlefront, putting her through two tables. Now Samus cutting the ring in half, making the tag to Daisy, and now looks like we're going to see some double team action coming up here. Double superplex right from the top rope. The field is now wide open for Daisy. Irish whip, hard fist, and a bulldog. Katana with a sweeping kick and a frontward moonsault. Another moonsault, but she missed the mark. That was a botched moment right there. And now Daisy sees the opportunity. Katana made a mistake, and now Daisy's going to capitalize. Wait a minute, Katana, Irish whip to the corner. Now Katana's cutting the ring in half, and she makes the tag to Melina. And Melina, with a hard kick using her knees, floors Daisy. Kick. Again. Another kick. Melina just taunting Samus. Daisy with a bulldog to Melina. The women's tag team champions are doing their best to not be intimidated by their challengers. And Melina just slapped Daisy. I gotta believe that's a form of psych out via the challengers. And Melina just continuing to ram Daisy's head into the canvas and... Daisy makes the tag to Samus. Samus getting a little frustrated over what Melina was doing to Daisy. But nonetheless, the balls are in the challenger's court right now. I think thanks to that psych out, Katana and Melina have had the advantage so far, but now Samus is trying to make her way up. Not for long. Floors Samus again and is focusing on that bad ankle. Oh, Samus just kicked her off again. And the tag to Daisy.
Very short shifts for Samus.
And now Daisy going after Melina's feet, I guess as revenge for what she's been doing to Samus. And considering Melina focuses a lot on kicks, that's not such a bad strategy. Now Daisy stretching the hamstring of Melina. Daisy's still at the wrong side of town, but she Irish whips Melina to the other side. Here's a tag again. We'll see a double team maneuver right here. Double backdrop. Samus with a backflip. The crowd in Vegas is really enjoying it, but Melina makes a tag to Katana. And wait a minute, Samus just picked up Katana and a backbreaker. And Samus just flattens Katana again. Now Katana once again going after the ankles of Samus. Oh! Samus flips Katana to the other side. Samus brings Katana back into the ring the hard way. But then again, is there an easy way ever to get in that ring? And now Daisy's been tagged in. And here's the pin. One. Two. No! There's a jawjacker. Hard splash. Here comes the Sarasalan DDT. Just planted Katana with it. She's going for the pin. But we know Melina's not going to be too far away. One. And Melina saves the match for her team. And Samus tries to come in. It's a Donnybrook now. Hard flying kick. Daisy attempted another splash, but to no avail. And now Katana. Unique move right there. I think that was Katana's own version of the Styles Clash.
And these two have finally given a name to that move. They call it the Twin Tower.
The Twin Tower. Is this going to be it? One, two, three. We got new women's tag team champions.
Winners of this bout and new women's tag team champions, Melina and Katana.
Daisy. Samus and Daisy retreat to the back. Katana and Melina, I gotta give props. They won this match fair and square. They're the new women's tag team champions. But I have reason to believe that Daisy and Samus will be back in the women's tag team championship hunt.
Perhaps there may be a third and deciding matchup.
You never know. But here it is, folks. This is the main event. The Primetime Championship to be decided as the undefeated German Giant Gigant, who is 24-0, going up against the challenger, Iron Man. And the Walt Disney Corporation has been making life miserable for a lot of competitors in the 20th Century Fox division, namely Gigant. But he hopes to put them away once and for all and make himself 25-0.
The following contest is our main event, scheduled for one fall, and it is for the TWA Primetime Championship. Introducing first, the challenger, accompanied by the Walt Disney Corporation from Malibu, California, weighing in 310 pounds, Iron Man!
There you see Iron Man, but he's not alone. He's got Kylo Ren, Captain Jack Sparrow, and of course their manager, Homer Simpson.
Now, before I put her in your place, my viewer, I think now is a good time to bring up one of the terms for our match. I don't know if Jones already told you, but in the fine print of my contract, it states that this primetime title match is no disqualification. Didn't you see it, Jones? Or are those binoculars on your face still not powerful enough? Well, bottom line, Gigant, my colleagues have every right to stay out here. So, good luck, pal.
Oh, shit.
And his opponent from Munich, Germany, weighing in at 365 pounds, he is the TWA Primetime Champion, Gigant!
Thanks to a very, very, very last minute amendment, those Disney goons are going to be able to interfere however many times they want.
So essentially, Gigant is going to be dealing with a 4-on-1 handicap match, so to speak. He not only has to worry about Iron Man, but he's got to worry about Kylo Ren, Captain Jack Sparrow, and Homer Simpson on the outside. think Gigant is going to have to at least bide his time here. If he's going to make Iron Man the 25th victim. Of course, all of this is still part of the ongoing border dispute, if you will, between the 20th Century Fox division and these Walt Disney invaders. Iron Man and his entourage, so to speak, have made the claim that they own the 20th Century Fox division, but there are some wrestlers, including the primetime champion Gigant, who still don't recognize it as an official group. Now, Gigant may not have the experience of an Iron Man, but he's got youth on his side. He's got the primetime title, and he's got the streak. Gigant keeping a close eye on the rest of the members of the Walt Disney Corporation. Oh, Iron Man comes right back with a flying clothesline. Just yanked him by the neck there.
I'm pretty sure that Iron Man would not be able to do that if he wasn't wearing the suit.
Iron Man may have been able to snap his fingers against Thanos, but I have great doubt that he's going to be able to do the same to the undefeated German giant. Oh, Iron Man just took his near 300-pound frame and tossed him across the ring, but Gigant not having any of that. And now the Teutonic Tower of Terror keeping his eyes on Homer Simpson, the Walt Disney Corporation's manager, who was instrumental in helping Iron Man defeat Fernando Stryker to get the number one contendership to the title here tonight. Now Iron Man with a pump handle slam. So far the balls are in Iron Man's court, but Gigant had the ropes. Now a chiropractic adjustment the hard way. Homer enjoying what he sees.
Homer is in fact one of the 24 unlucky victims on Gigant's list, so perhaps he would take great pleasure in seeing Iron Man end it.
And of course, Kylo Ren on the outside was another one of Gigant's victims. The Teutonic Tower of Terror defeated Kylo Ren on the last battlefront. Gigant with the simplex. Iron Man going for a chin lock, but Gigant now reverses it, and he had the chin lock on himself briefly. Iron Man clotheslines to the outside, and now Captain Jack Sparrow, unfortunately, it's legal. Dugont just floors Captain Jack Sparrow. One down, three more to go. But Iron Man with an underhook suplex. Or I believe that was a fisherman suplex. Irish whip. Iron Man with a knee. Ghost top rope high risk. Double drop kick. I'm not going to count Gigant out just yet, because he's been in tougher situations. We all saw what Gigant was made of when he faced Karras at Telethon 7. Oh, Iron Man just comes through. And Gigant is angry. One clothesline, two clotheslines. And a butt bump. And the German Giant just brings all of his entire weight down on Iron Man. Now the Walt Disney Corporation starting to sweat. Inverted DDT.
And they better be sweating because they know what's coming up next.
This is a setup for the consequence. Gigant just has to land this for the victory. But he's getting distracted by Homer Simpson on the outside there. And here it comes. And the consequence. There it is. And here's the pin. But referee is distracted by Homer Simpson. Needless to say, Homer saved the match for Iron Man. And now, Gigant going after Kylo Ren. Hard shot to Homer Simpson again. Maybe Gigant can survive after all. And plants Kylo Ren again. And he plants Jack Sparrow for good measure.
He's leveling them all.
Kylo Ren almost ran into Homer. But wait a minute. Iron Man now seizes the advantage and drapes Gigant's face on the edge of the apron. I don't think there's any countouts either. Gigant had the match won, but of course the Walt Disney Corporation, we knew they were going to stick their nose into this match, considering it's now no disqualification out of nowhere. Gigant throws Iron Man to the outside. And now the Teutonic Tower of Terror is making a veiled threat to the rest of the Disney goons. And he hits Homer with a big boot. And now Kylo Ren and Captain Jack Sparrow are waiting in the wings. Iron Man now has the advantage again. Oh, and there's the Infinity Gauntlet out of nowhere. And here's the pin. One, two. Oh! Gigant is still alive. And now Iron Man really stretching the spine of the German Giant. But Gigant finds a way to break out of it. Tried to go for, I guess, a dropkick to the knees, but he was nowhere near the mark. Maybe Gigant's just all disoriented. The Primetime Champion still going strong. forward elbow. Jagat comes right back up. Kylo Ren, Jack Sparrow, and Homer still standing patiently on the outside. One. Two. Iron Man gets the shoulder up.
Jagat's been keeping his head on a swivel this whole match.
Jagat is keeping the pressure on Iron Man. Tony Stark comes right back with a dive. And now wait. Oh, yeah. I forgot. No disqualification. And now Kylo Ren and Jack Sparrow setting Iron Man up for the triple power bomb. They did this to Fernando Stryker on Battlefront. And Iron Man with a pin. One. Two. Oh, Jagat is still alive again. There's an uppercut. Chop. But Kylo Ren and Homer Simpson are still jumping for joy, sensing that there's victory afoot. Speaking of foot, Jagat stopping a mud hole in Iron Man and walking it dry. There's a backdrop. Hard clothesline. Jagat goes to the outside. Now what is Iron Man going to do here? He's got a steel chair. It's all legal, unfortunately.
Jagat should fight fire with fire. He should use the chair.
Jagat with a jawjacker. Hard fist. And a boot right to the back. Throws Iron Man right back in. Jagat is in no mood for any more games from Iron Man and the Walt Disney Corporation. Iron Man with an Irish whip. And oh, Jagat with a choke slam. Now what's the German Giant going to do here? Looks like he took too much time, and Iron Man capitalizes with a football-like clip to the knee. Iron Man trying a suplex, but Jagat comes right back. Whatever Jagat was planning to do there, the ropes broke it up. Here's the pin. One. Two. Very close. Jagat was sensing his 25th victory in just one fraction of a second away. And Homer Simpson really getting in Jagat's face. And that distraction just cost Jagat dearly. Suplex by Iron Man. Now he's going high risk. This is where Iron Man is at his best. Oh! He missed the mark! And Jagat now capitalizes with a Russian leg sweep. Or should we say, German leg sweep. Shot. The Walt Disney Corporation has got to be reconsidering their plans right now. They got to be thinking, what can be done to defeat this giant? and a rare submission hold by the German giant. But Iron Man kicks away. Massive drop kick. And now Iron Man going full force. Spear. Gigant's on the outside now, where Kylo Ren and Homer Simpson are, and that's not good for the Teutonic Tower of Terror. And Homer with a hard swing to the back of Gigant. But the German giant just flipped Iron Man off the apron. Homer Simpson now giving words to Gigant, shoves him out of the way. Iron Man with a hard shot. Now we're seeing the steel steps come into play. Once again, it's all legal. Iron Man. Oh, Gigant just wrestled the steel steps out of Iron Man's grip. Now Gigant going for another submission, but Iron Man used the ropes. That's the veteran instincts of Tony Stark. Now Homer tossing a chair in the ring for Iron Man to use, but he's still unconscious at this point. One. Only a one count. Iron Man with a fist, an uppercut. Iron Man using the steel chair over and over, but Gigant gets out of the way, and a bulldog. Homer Simpson getting himself involved once again.
In half a year, Homer sure has become a real pest.
There's a Samoan drop by Iron Man. Gigant with a massive boot. And Gigant with an inverted DDT. I don't think we're still anywhere near a winner at this point. Because even though Gigant has been making pretty good use of his offense against Iron Man, he still has the Walt Disney goons on the outside making sure that he doesn't win. And Gigant going for the consequence for the second time. Walt Disney Corporation getting angry. And here's the pin again. And once again, Homer making sure that the match is not over.
Come on, referee. Isn't his eject gauge empty yet?
And Iron Man with a drop kick. Going for the steel chair now. I guess weapons are all that Iron Man can use to defeat Gigant at this point. It's been two times now that Gigant has had the match won, but the Walt Disney Corporation has already proven to be very efficient at Iron Man's side. One, two. Gigant, gorilla press slam. Neither man budges. Hard knee to the face. Iron Man with a hard headbutt. Here's the pin. That's not going to keep Gigant down. Forget about it. A lot of wrestlers have made the mistake of going after Gigant's cranium. Gigant once again going for a submission hold. Homer Simpson getting frantic. But Iron Man reaches the ropes. German Giant once again getting distracted by Homer Simpson.
Oh, finally.
And now referee Jordan Peterson has finally had it with Homer Simpson, and now he's ejecting him. Here's the pin. One. Two. No. Nonetheless, you still have Kylo Ren and Captain Jack Sparrow on the outside. There's an overhead belly-to-belly suplex. Now Gigant once again going for that submission maneuver. Man going high risk. There's a skydive. And looks like he's setting Gigant up to go for the Infinity Gauntlet once again. There's the Infinity Gauntlet. And here's the pin. One, two. Gigant is still in the game. And Iron Man is getting pissed off. He is getting angry. He's swinging at air. Once again, resorting to use of the steel steps.
Sounds like he's trying to orchestrate another triple powerbomb with his buddies.
Now Iron Man actually picking up Gigant's weight into a rib breaker. Here's the pin. I don't think that's going to keep him down. And now he's summoned Kylo Ren and Jack Sparrow into the ring once again, setting him up for a triple powerbomb, this time from the top rope. Oh boy. Oh boy. And oh! And the referee has had it with Kylo Ren's interference, and now he's ejecting him from the premise.
It might be too late, though.
Jack Sparrow and Kylo Ren have been ejected. One, two, no! Gigant is still alive! And this time, Iron Man has no help left. The Walt Disney Corporation were all sent to the back.
Perhaps Gigant can pull this off. Plan A and B haven't worked.
And now Gigant picking up Iron Man's carcass, floating into an inverted DDT. All he's got to do is nail the consequence again. One clothesline, two clotheslines, and a butt bump, and lands his entire weight on Tony Stark. Inverted DDT again, and wait a minute, there's the Incredible Hulk. Or should we say, the adorable Hulk?
I think that might be Plan C.
And oh, the ad- adorable Hulk just planted Gigant and a knee, and now, oh, Hulk bomb! We've forgotten about the Hulk. Now Iron Man, he's the only one showing life so far. Gigant has been planted. And now, the Infinity Gauntlet, third time. The pin. One, two, three! Gigant is 24-1.
The winner of this bout and new primetime champion.
Yay! Good job, Tony!
Iron Man!
Iron Man is the one in 24-1. Gigant's streak has come to an end. I can't believe it. Hope you enjoyed our show, everybody. You can follow us on Instagram. Hit that like button. Comment as you see fit. After that ending, I don't know what to make of the events in the Television Wrestling Association now. Thanks for joining us, everybody. RJ Peckham and Mark Adams signing off.